now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
The power of the houses. A house gains strength in the following way: when it contains a benefic or when it is aspected by a benefic. When his lord is in a Kendra or a Trikona house. When his lord is exalted or in his own sign. When his lord is in a house of a friend or a great friend. When his lord is aspected by benefics. When both the house and the lord are not damaged by malefics, either through aspecting or through malefics in the house. A house loses its strength in the following way: when it has a malefic in it or when it is aspected by a malefic. When its lord is in the 6th, 8th or 12th house. When his lord is in a trap. When his lord is in the house or sign of an enemy or a great enemy. When his lord is aspected by malefics and not by benefics. However, malefics are welcome in the Upachaya houses, 3, 6, 10 and 11. In these houses they will function better as the years pass. The growth in the 3rd house is the least spectacular in this respect, while the 11th house shows the strongest growth. The signs on the ascendant. When people in India ask about your zodiac sign, they want to know what the sign on your ascendant is and the sign in which your moon is located and not what your sun sign is. In fact, the sun is considered a malefic and is absolutely subordinate to the sign, and lord, of the ascendant. The ascendant is the person, along with the position of the moon. At least, it is mainly these influences from which one initially reads the character, although the character data in itself is less important than concrete results. Because the ascendant is so important, here are some instructions, taken from classical astrology. Naturally, the descriptions that follow are not colored by other influences. They serve as an indication, a direction that you can take into account in the overall assessment. Ascendant Aries, Mesha. Independent thinkers and doers, enjoy a scientific and philosophical approach, enjoy helping to broaden other people's horizons, for example through education, are stubborn but also open, impulsive, brave and combative, pioneers. They are not practical, gossip, love beauty and art. Their build is slender, the head is fairly long, wide at the temples and narrow at the chin. Women have beautiful contours. Taurus Ascendant, Vrishabha. Owners of Taurus Ascendant have their own principles and ways of doing things. They often have a penetrating intellect. They are good writers, booksellers and journalists. They are not, or rarely, guided by sentiments, but by the true background of something. They have an exceptional ability to memorize and remember things. Have business instincts and good intuition. They think they were born to exercise their authority, are often overzealous and easily persuaded to counterfeit or falsify things. Their build is stocky and of medium height, with a square face, thick neck and muscular shoulders. Ascendant Gemini, Mithuna. Have a curious and associative mind, are jacks of all trades but are not thoroughly skilled in anything unless Saturn occupies a strong position in the horoscope. They are lively, flirtatious in nature and therefore need discipline in dealing with the opposite sex. They are always aware of their own mistakes, tend to cheat and commit fraud. Their build is long, the legs thin, with long hands and fingers. The gaze is often sharp and the nose is long or sometimes somewhat flattened. Ascendant Cancer, Kataka, are frugal and frugal, sometimes verging on miserly, intelligent, sympathetic, not really brave, attached to family and children, extremely sensitive to mood and atmosphere, which often leads to nervousness and eccentricity. They have a preference for production and trade. Often become disappointed in their marital life and in their love relationships. Like to talk, are honest but unyielding. Saturn on the ascendant has a very negative effect on this, opposite its own sign. Their build is average in size, with slender arms and legs but a broad upper body and a large belly with age. Since the upper body is large compared to the arms and legs, it appears top-heavy. The face is round with large mouth and ears. Ascendant Leo, Simha. Ambitious, independent thinkers know how to adapt well to different living conditions, are tolerant of those who think differently, but are themselves attached to orthodox religious views on life. Love music, dance and drama. They like to read and therefore also have philosophical knowledge. Their build is sturdy and tall, with broad shoulders and forehead, strong muscles and majestic appearance.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Until the next time, much love.